Good day, cadets. Today, in this video, we will discuss about the variation, deviation, compass error, and how to determine each one of those. So, I hope you will like this video and you will learn something.
There are factors that we need to remember when correcting compass, namely the tube bearing, variation, magnetic heading, deviation, and compass heading. There are two formulas or abbreviations we need to remember, the TVMDC or the True Virgin Make Dog Company plus Whiskey minus Ethics, and the CDMVT or Candid Man Vote Twice minus Whiskey plus Ethics. Now, we have a scenario in which we determine compass error if the variation is 10 degrees west and the deviation is 7 degrees east. So, we have the given variation of 10 degrees west and the deviation 3 degrees east. So, simply subtract these two because we have a rule that if it is in the same name, we add, but if it has the different name, we need to subtract. So we get the compass error of 7 degrees westerly. So westerly because the greater value is the 10 degrees, which is west. So we just need to copy that value. Your vessel's heading is 245 degrees PGC with a 4 degrees east compass error. If there is a variation of 2 degrees east, what is the deviation of this heading? In the given scenario, we have a given of 245 degrees compass heading and variation of 2 degrees east and a compass error of 4 degrees easterly. In determining the deviation, we all need to have the compass error and variation. So the compass error is 4 degrees east and the variation is 2 degrees east. But we need to remember this important rule, which is to always reverse the sign of the variation and apply the first rule, different name, subtract, and same name, just simply add. So here we have a deviation of 2 degrees easterly. This time, we can use the CDMVT formula because we already identified the deviation. So here we can now solve for our true heading and a true course of our vessel. The compass bearing of the leading lights is 75 degrees and true bearing leading light is 69 degrees true. Find the compass error. In finding compass error, there are notes or rule that we need to remember. If the compass is less than true bearing, the error is east. If compass is greater than true bearing, the error is west. So going back to the problem, we have a true bearing of 69 degrees true and the compass bearing of 75 degrees true. So directly subtract these two, then we get the compass error of 6 degrees west. The course bearing lighthouse is 98 degrees and the variation 3 degrees west and the deviation is 5 degrees easterly. Calculate the true bearing. So we have a given of 3 degrees west and a deviation of 5 degrees east. So just simply subtract these two to get the compass error 2 degrees east. And to find the true bearing, we have a given of compass bearing of the lighthouse 098 degrees and our calculated compass error is 2 degrees east. So we get the true bearing of 100 degrees true. The true bearing of a lighthouse is 147 degrees and the variation is 3 degrees west. The deviation is 4 degrees west. Find the compass bearing. In finding compass bearing, we will use the formula TVMDC. So we are given the true bearing of 147 degrees and the variation is 3 degrees west. So we all know that when the variation is west, we will add that. So the result will be 150 degrees. So the given deviation was 4 degrees west. Simply we just add that to the magnetic course, we get 150 plus 4 equals 154 degrees compass bearing. In updating variation in compass rose, there are important notes that we need to remember. If the variation and total change is the same name, we should always add. But if the variation and the total change have different name, we should subtract. Here, we have a sample of a compass rose which has a variation of 4 degrees 15 minutes west in the year 2009 with 8 minutes east annual change. To update this variation to our current year, to 2022, we have a formula. Just simply put the given variation, 4 degrees 15 minutes west annual change 8 degrees east. Then the required year, which is 2022, then subtract the required year and the charted year, so we got the time interval of 13 years. Next, we will multiply it by the 8 minutes east annual change, and the result will be 1 degrees and 44 minutes easterly total change. To get this, we just need to have a scientific calculator. Then lastly, the variation of 2009 will be subtracted to the total change we calculated. So as I mentioned earlier, if it has different names, we will subtract it. Then we get an updated variation of 2009 compass rose, which is 2 degrees 31 minutes west in the year 2022. So that's all. I hope you learned something today, and if you have questions, just comment below and don't forget to subscribe.